We just can't stop draining things over here at Life's Biggest Questions. Hey, listen, we got given a few water drainage pumps for Christmas, and we're trying to put them to good use before we re-gift them to our unsavory cousins. Don't worry about it, alright? Nevertheless, draining things is actually pretty damn fun, because for the most part, oceans and expansive bodies of water have a habit of hiding some pretty intriguing mysteries down within the deep dark bowels of the murky blue. And perhaps the most mysterious of them all is up there at the frozen north. So, let's take a look, shall we? Hello internet, what's going on? And once again, welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today we curiously ask the question, what if we drained the Arctic Ocean? Roll the clip. For the curious amongst you, that clip was from 2007's 30 Days of Night, a fantastic film that depicts the northernmost town of Barrow, Alaska, because, hey, we're trying to depict an Arctic drained of all water, but instead we'll have to depict an Arctic town drained of all blood. Hey, Alaskan vampires, what can I say? It's a bad pun, but it kind of works. The point is, that cinematic landscape of a view may be pretty similar given the parameters of this hypothetical situation, but without further delay, why don't we just dive on into the frigid, ice-cold waters? Our first port of call, which would perhaps be the most appropriate, is to outline all of the many idiosyncrasies of the Arctic Ocean, which isn't really an ocean at all, but more of a sea, or an estuary, really. Still, it's a fascinating place, so let's take a look as to why. The Arctic Ocean is the smallest and shallowest of the world's five major oceans, although some oceanographers do remain steadfast in its classification as a sea, a partially enclosed coastal body of water with a free connection to the open sea, which has a few technical implications for our particular hypothetical situation, but we'll get to those in good time. The Arctic Ocean is seen as the northernmost part of the all-encompassing global ocean, and that in itself is why it's so damn important, because the first glaringly obvious point to this Life's Biggest Question is that if we drain the Arctic Ocean, we'd all die. But hey, that doesn't make for any entertaining hypotheticals, does it? So let's put the Arctic in a protective little hypothetical bubble and see how we'd fare if we started draining the ocean, and more importantly, what would be revealed. Besides its surrounding waters, the Arctic Ocean is bordered by both Eurasia and North America. For the most part, it is sporadically covered by sea ice, which unfortunately for us is diminishing, and in water, it is completely comprised of ice. The small area that encapsulates the Arctic Ocean is bordered by Russia, Canada, the northernmost tip of Norway, Iceland, the entirety of Greenland, and the northernmost tip of Alaska. So there, in effect, we have a checklist of where we would need to dam in order to allow the draining to begin. And I mean, holy moly, that's one heck of a feat of engineering. It's making me stressed already a little bit. Put it this way, the Arctic Ocean occupies a roughly circular basin that covers an area of around 5.427 million square miles. Its coastline is 28,000 miles long. And you can kind of see where we're going with this one, right? The biggest dam ever built on planet Earth is the Three Gorges Dam that spans the Yangtze River and covers 1.4 miles. It is the largest feat of modern engineering on planet Earth, and it's 1.4 miles in length. 1.4. Yeah, we need a dam that covers 28,000 miles in order to drain the Arctic Ocean. Now, it is estimated that the Three Gorges Dam cost around a whopping $24 billion to construct, and at first glance, you could imagine that a dam that size that we needed in this hypothetical scenario would cost somewhere in the ballpark of 28,000 times that cost, which is roughly $672 trillion. That's over six times the amount of the entire planet's economy. So theoretically, we'd need six economies to pay for it, all working simultaneously to pump out enough gross world product to pay for this particularly problematic Arctic dam. But hey, we could probably shave off a huge chunk of the cost given the fact that we just need something big and tall enough to act as a physical barrier whilst we start pumping all of that water away. Which leads us to our next problematic venture, draining the Arctic Ocean. And you thought building the dam was hard because it's only about to get harder. Put it this way, the Arctic Ocean has a total volume of 18.07 times 10 to the power of 6 kilometers cubed. That's 1.9 times 10 to the power of 15 liters. In other terms, it's about 1.3% of the world's ocean. That's big. That's a lot of water. Also, we haven't even spoken about the fact that this Arctic Ocean, well, it's Arctic. The majority of it is comprised of the Arctic ice pack, and as the laws of thermodynamics dictate, there's going to be a few ice cubes left behind if we start draining this whole thing. Alright, so then, how would we even begin to drain the Arctic Ocean and hope to shift that much water and, who knows, bottle it up and sell it as the world's purest and coldest ice water? Hey, That's capitalism, right? And no one's doubting the questionable ethics of this whole hypothetical scenario anyway, but that's by the by. Okay, within these hypothetical parameters, I'm pretty sure it's safe to say that getting a series of pumps to shift the Arctic Ocean is completely out of the question. So we're going to have to rely on the same magical hypothetical plug hole that worked for us back in our What If We Drained the Ocean video. All right, the flow rate of our magical plug hole is around 43,200 litres per day. Again, the volume of the Arctic Ocean is about 1.9 trillion cubic litres. If we divide that by the rate in which the water would flow down the magical hypothetical plug hole, it would take around 227 million years for it to be fully drained. And even then, it wouldn't be entirely drained, given the fact that the topography of the Arctic Ocean is all over the shop, and there'd be entire craters worth of small oceans still bobbing about regardless as to where we began draining. So yeah, if all of this doesn't sound off-putting enough, given the fact that we'd be going to incomprehensible lengths that would see humanity undertaking the largest engineering event in the history of our planet with a sprinkling of hypothetical magic, you might think, is it all worth it? And the short answer is no, not at all. The Arctic Ocean has been frozen for millennia. It's the polar ice cap, for crying out loud. Although it's considered that the Arctic Ocean used to harbor plant life that existed there as recently as 5,500 years ago, with ocean cores that date back around 8,000 years to the last warm period of 125,000 years ago during the last interglacial period, the likelihood of going to such great lengths of draining the ocean would be ridiculous, given the fact that we could just, you know, send a submarine down there and see what all the fuss is about. Hell, with the way that things are going, it's estimated that the Arctic Ocean may experience ice-free summers by as early as 2040. So we'd probably save more money by killing off the planet instead of building a giant dam, hoping for a hypothetical plug hole to show up, and then waiting 227 million years for the whole thing to be done and dusted. Now, there's no doubt that our civilization would serve to learn a lot about ourselves if we had carte blanche on the many mysteries of the Arctic ice, but yeah, if we're that curious about the Arctic, we should probably just drill it or something. Yeah, that sounds like a much better idea. Well, there we have it, our long and short answer to the question, what if we drained the Arctic Ocean? What do you guys think? Do you agree, disagree, have any more to add to this hypothetical horror show? Then let us know your thoughts down in the comment section below, as well as any choice picks of your own. Before we depart from today's video, if you'd like to continue on with your questioning binge, please feel free to take a look at our neatly compiled playlist, efficiently arranged for your viewing enjoyment, many of which involve draining massive bodies of water. On that note, unfortunately, that's all we've got time for in today's video. Just stick around all the way until the end. If you were a fan of this video, or just Life's Biggest Questions in general, then please be a dear and hit that thumbs up button, as well as that subscribe bell, and I'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions, and until next time, don't drain the Arctic Ocean and take it easy.